guys, laying here. Louis is asleep because he edited all night last night. And it's 5 a.m. on the last day, and we got waves! Yeah, dude!
Guys, I'm finally out of bed. Lane,
this guy's so lazy.
Lane took you surfing this morning.
Oh, dude, there's alcohol in there.
I'm kind of upset that I missed the waves, but we're just having a little drink before lunch. Is this alcoholic? Is it?
Uh-oh.
I'm getting a coffee. No, I don't think it is, bro.
Really?
No, we're good. Okay. Cheers. We wanted to order a Coke, but this is an empty can of Coke in the fridge. I don't know why they've done that. It's funny. But anyway, I'm getting a coffee, which I'm very, very excited about. One of the gifts that we're leaving the team is this cafetiere, and Bridget's just teaching them how to make coffee with it. So Bridget's just, she's just teaching them how to do the Tim Tam Slam. Right, diagonal corners, yeah. And then, yeah, you got that. You got that.
Corner, you stick it in, and you're gonna suck, really, like, suck it up like a straw, and then slam it in your mouth.
I remember when Andy showed me this. Oh, there we go.
Yeah, suck.
Really hard. Are you getting it?
She's eating.
You got it.
Did you get it?
I did it.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Eat it. Oh, I fell in the coffee. That's exactly what I did for my first Tim Tam Slam as well. Oh, it's getting messy. Did yours fall in the coffee as well? It fell in.
No, she ate it off.
Well, I finally made it out. Outside. This is the first time I've been outside today. It's not that I'm lazy, I just needed to rest, guys. And it's been a lovely day so far. But I'm about to go and do some surfing. We need to film a few more shots for the music video. We're gonna try and get Daniel doing some dancing. We're trying to persuade Miss Kim to do a few more verses, singing some stuff. And then we're gonna try to cut some of it together tonight. But yeah. It's gonna be fun. Guys, we are getting some amazing breakdancing shots of Daniel. Lane's pushing me on the penny board.
Sit life.
It's so good. Check this out. Yeah. Woo! Yes, bro. We got the shots. Woo, it is warm out here. We just need to go find Miss Kim now.
some of the kids have finally come over. It's been pretty cool today because, unlike other days, we haven't been like segregated from the rest of the beach like goers, and we've just been chilling with the locals. And now Aquila's grabbed some of the kids and taken them out on the board. It's pretty cool.
Wait for it, hold on. Can you hear it a little bit?
Yeah.
Are you ready? One, two, three, four, what? No.
Oh, well, I can't remember at the moment.
Ready?
It's good, it's good.
It's so good.
Restart, it's so good, it's so good.
Oh my gosh, so beautiful.
We finally got Miss Kim to do another singing part just before the sun fully setted.
It was beautiful.
It was so good.
So beautiful.
I've really been struggling to edit out here because we've been getting up super early and then we've been having team meetings till late, so.
Long days and a lot of footage.
Yeah, and I've been trying to catch up with some sleep whilst I'm out here. But yeah, we're gonna go and have another dinner by the beach now, a little barbecue.
We wanna, on behalf of Surfing the Nations and all our friends from all over the world, we wanna say thank you very much to all of you, because you're all surfers now, yeah? So we just wanna say thank you. This is like, guys, this is our final farewell banquet.
2014, I brought the first surf camp to DPRK with Surfing the Nations. And since then, we've had three now surf camps successfully run, and then we've seen other group come in two times, and they'll come in again in September. So that's going to be six surfing groups, big surfing groups in 3 years. We have boogie boards here and surfing equipment here. And so we're seeing local people enjoying riding the waves. And so I hope that you will continue to surf whenever you get the chance, and you improve your skills. And as I was sharing with Mr. Jung, surfing will become an Olympic sport someday, hopefully soon. Yeah. It will. There's a man-made wave pool that it gives the potential for surfing in the Olympics. And who knows? Maybe one of you can represent your country on your official Olympic surfing team in the future.
That was a really nice evening. It was so cool to be able to encourage the guides that have been with us this week. And it's crazy how far things have come in the last few days, just in terms of the friendships that have been built, and just how relaxed everything has become. And I have, this has just been quite incredible. I'm kind of sad that I won't be able to stay in touch with people here very easily. It's been very different for me. My time here in North Korea has been a break from the internet. That wasn't a voluntary break, but it's kind of worked out nicely that I haven't had my phone out all the time like usual. Also, stuff I haven't told you guys, there's no ATMs here, so I've only had this little wad of yen, Chinese money, with me, and it's lasted, which has been good. What else? I don't know, there's just so much to grasp. Like, the girls we've chatted to just haven't, I was chatting to one of them and they'd never heard of Wi-Fi. I was like, is there Wi-Fi at the hotel? And they were like, what's that? And then Miss Kim the other day had never heard of Justin Bieber. There's, you know, this whole other kind of, almost like the separate civilization that is just very separate. The music we've been listening to the entire time has been just, you know, this whole other music, which
isn't stuff that we usually listen to. We're leaving here tomorrow morning. We're hopefully going to get up for one last surf. I'm kind of sad I missed the waves this morning, but yeah, we had fun in the waves this afternoon. But yeah, I'm going to get up at 6, I think. And yeah, then we're doing a long coach ride back to Pyongyang. I'll catch you in the morning. Peace out, enjoy life, and live the adventure. Boom.